Hello, my name is Niamh. I am from Breakthrough Maths and welcome to this step-by-step tutorial on how to prove that cos A minus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sin A sin B. So this proof involves a construction, which is what you can see in front of you. And using this construction, we are then going to do a small mathematical proof. So let's start off with building the construction.
Okay, so the construction for this proof just involves drawing a unit circle. Okay, a unit circle is a circle with the radius of 1. Now, we don't have to worry about making it a specific radius. So we don't have to worry about making it 1 centimeter or 1 inch. You know, we can just label the radius as 1 because it can be in whatever unit, you know, we decide. So draw a circle whatever size you want, basically. So just taking your compass, you're going to trace out your circle. Now, I'm going to go over it a second time just so it makes it a bit more bold and we can all see it a little bit more clearly. You probably don't need to do this. Okay. Now, guys, I want you to find the center of the circle, so the point that the compass pierced the paper, okay? And I want you to color it in quite strongly so that we know exactly where the center of the circle is. So taking your pencil, you're going to find the center and you're going to draw a nice big dot in the center of the circle, okay? Okay, cool. Now, the next thing is you're going to take your ruler and we're going to draw a horizontal line through the center of the circle. Taking our ruler, draw a horizontal line through the center of the circle, so something like this. Now I'm going to mark this, okay, and it doesn't go down at the end like mine does. I'm going to mark this as 0 degrees. Okay, so basically what I'm saying is this is the point 0 degrees. If I go further up, this is going to be like 45 degrees, you know, it's going to be 90 degrees. 180 degrees and so on and so forth. I'm just marking this point as the point of 0 degrees. Okay, you're now going to take, again, you're doing all this in pencil. I'm doing it in pen so we can see a bit more clearly. But we're now going to draw a radius, okay? So we're going to, from the center to the circumference, going to mark in a radius. Okay, and that's the point Q. Labeling this as the point Q. Similarly, I'm going to mark in another radius. And we're going to call this the point P. Okay. I'm now going to join the point P and Q. Again, using our ruler, nice straight lines. Let's join the points P and Q. Perfect. Okay. Now we said this is a unit circle, so we can mark the radius size as 1 on all of these. Okay, so this is the point 1, and this is the length 1, and this is also the length of 1. Okay. Now I'm going to call the angle from 0 degrees here up to this radius, which joins the point Q. I'm going to call this angle B. I'm not going to do the same thing. I'm going to draw a line from the point where the 0 degrees is all the way to the radius that joins up to the point P, and I'm going to call that angle A. So therefore, what is the angle between this radius and the other radius? Well, guys, it's the angle A minus B, and we're going to mark it in as such. Okay. Now, the point P has the coordinates. So if we're looking at this as coordinates, we're looking at this as the point 0, 0, the origin. Then the point P would have the coordinates cos of A, sine of A. And the point Q would have the coordinates cos of B, sine of B. We're now going to label these. This is x1, y1. This is x2, y2. Now that is your construction finished, guys. So whatever I add on drawing now, you do not need to include in your construction. If there's any confusion as to why cos this point Q is cos B sine B and this point P is cos A sine A, do me a favor, draw a dotted line to the bottom and across, And notice that this is a right angle triangle. Similarly, draw a dotted line here across. Notice that this is also a right angled triangle. Okay. Now, using that fact, try to think about why this is the point cos A sine A and the point cos B sine B. If you need a little bit of help, check out this other bit, this video, where I go into why this is. Okay.
Okay, and now we're ready to the mathematical part of the proof. So, what we're going to do actually is we're going to try to find this distance PQ using two different methods. Okay. And the first method that we're going to use is the distance formula. So the distance between two points. So let's just write that much down. So we're going to say that we're going to find PQ using two methods. And the first method, method one, I should say, is the distance formula. Okay, as a little reminder, the distance formula is the distance between two points on a plane is given by d is equal to the square root of x2 minus x1 all squared plus y2 minus y1 all squared. Now, we already have labeled those things in our construction, which is nice. So we have the cos A sine A is x1, y1, and cos B sine B is x2, y2. So we should sub it in, guys. Let's do that much. So that means that D is equal to the square root all of x2, we said is cos B, minus x1, which is cos A, all squared, plus y2, which is sine B, minus y1, which is sine A, and that's all squared. Okay, let's multiply these brackets, guys. If you want to do this quickly, we can use the method, which is that when you've got two terms in a square bracket, then all you need to do is you square the first plus two times first times the last plus square the last. So we've got D is equal to the square root all of cos squared B minus 2 cos A cos B plus cos squared A plus sine squared B minus 2 sine B sine A plus sine squared A. And we're going to square root this whole thing. Perfect. Okay, so now let's use the rule, guys, that if you have the squared cos of any angle plus the sine squared of any angle, theta, this is equal to 1. Okay, this is in your log tables, but I've also proved it in another video, so check that out if you haven't already. Okay, so let's apply that. Well, we've got a cos squared b plus a sine squared b, so that's going to be equal to 1. We've also got a cos squared a plus a sine squared a, and that's also going to be 1. So we can simplify this down. Square root of 1 plus 1 minus 2 cos b cos a. Guys, I've just switched the order of these. It doesn't matter. They're just multiplied together, okay? 2 cos b cos a minus 2 sine b sine a. 2, 1 plus 1 is 2. Again, this is all this distance we're looking for right here is PQ. So we've got this is 2 minus 2 cos. I can pull this minus 2 out in front of these. I've got cos b cos a plus sine B sine A. Now, getting rid of that square root, we're going to square both sides. PQ all squared, this side all squared, that's going to cancel with our square root. And after method one, we find that PQ squared, the distance PQ squared, is equal to 2 minus 2 all by cos B cos A plus sine B sine A. Cool. Okay. Now let's find the same distance and using method two. Now guys, this time we're going to use the cosine formula, right? I've just kind of pulled this blue triangle out here just to point something out to you. The cosine formula is simply given by a squared is equal to b squared plus c squared minus 2bc sine of, cos of a. Again, this is in your log tables. Again, I've proved it in another video in this series, okay? So, this formula directly corresponds to any triangle of this kind of structure, where we have the capital A represents the angle opposite the side of small a, and the B and C are the other two sides. So why don't we label it with whatever side, whatever labels we have here, okay? So A is our distance PQ. B here is just 1. C here is just 1. And our angle A here is A minus B. So let's just sub it in. So again, we have PQ squared, which is A squared, is equal to B squared, 1 squared, plus 1 squared for C squared, minus 2 by 1 by 1, cos of A minus B. 1 squared is just equal to 1, minus 2 times 1 times 1 is just minus 2. So we have, this is 2 minus 2 cos A minus B. Now at this point we've got two expressions for PQ squared and we can just let them equal each other, guys, okay? So we can say equate expressions for PQ squared from method 1 and 2. And what does that look like? Well, here we have PQ squared is 2 minus 2 cos of A minus B. And up above, we have that PQ squared is equal to 2 minus 2 cos B cos A plus sine B sine A. Is equal to 2 minus 2 cos B cos A plus sine B sine A. Now, if we take 2 away from both sides, guys, we're going to get rid of this 2, and that's fine. Those cancel. If we divide both sides by minus 2, then this minus 2 multiplying each of these is also going to cancel. Whatever we do to the one side, we have to the other. And look at what we're left with, guys. Exactly what we were trying to prove, that cos A minus B is equal to cos B cos A plus sine B sine A, and you are done. Now you might notice that the order of this is slightly different to what is it given your log tables, which is cos A cos B sine A sine B. We have cos B cos A sine B sine A. Absolutely fine, doesn't matter, it's the exact same thing. In fact, you can just let it equal, okay? Because these are just multiplied together, so the order doesn't matter. So if we want to be very precise, we can then rearrange it to look like this. And there you have it, guys.